Hello students, welcome to our Neat Chemistry Trick channel. So today we are going to discuss about the topic of phenol. So in that particular topic we are going to discuss about the reaction involving a cleavage of carbon and oxygen bond, how the cleavage is happening between the carbon and oxygen bond. Okay, so carbon and oxygen bond, how the cleavage is happening through the phenol. Okay, whether it is, if you take alcohol, the phenol group also you can take, otherwise the aliphatic alcohol also you can take. Okay, so we are going to discuss about how the reaction involving the cleavage of carbon and oxygen bond. Okay, so with the alcohol you can take. Okay, with the alcohols, so that's we are going to discuss today. So between that I will give you the important points, how we can how the formation of the particular compound will we will get, whether it is a ethane and methane. Okay, in the end product you will get the ethane, otherwise butane or something else. Okay, according to the starting product. So how we can able to get the final product, and what is the tips we have to follow for it, and what is the beginning in that particular mechanism. Okay, so all those things we are going to learn today. So don't skip the video, so see fully, so it's so that only you will get a better clarification about the particular mechanism and also the dehydration of particular the cleavage bond, that means the carbon and the oxygen bond. Okay, how it is happening in the alcohol. Fine. Okay, let's go to the session now. We are going to discuss about the dehydration today. Alcohol dehydration, how the dehydration is happening in the alcohol according to the cleavage of, okay, according to the cleavage of bond between the carbon and oxygen bond. Fine. Okay, so the first things we have to see, keep it in your mind, that is the first thing is, okay, in the during the reaction, that means the dehydration reaction, what will happen? So it is a dehydration reaction. Okay, so it is a dehydration reaction in the alcohol. So according to this reaction, the alcohol will undergo the dehydration. Dehydration means there is a removal of molecular water, right? Dehydration is a removal of H2 molecule from the particular alcohol compound, right? And form a alkene. And okay, whether it is a ethane, whether it is a butane, it will form a alkene compound on treating with the protonic acid. Okay, protonic acid, whether you can take, that means the which you are taking acid, it should contain a hydrogen group, right? So H2SO4 you can take, otherwise no, H3PO4 you can take. Okay, so any other catalyst such as like anhydrous zinc chloride, aluminum, so like that. So which are the acid having a proton group, so that kind of acid you have to take for a catalyst during the reaction. So these are the things you have to keep in your mind. So what are the things we are going to learn today? That cleavage of carbon and oxygen bond, how it is happening in the particular alcohol, the dehydration means it is a removal of H2 molecule, that's it. Okay, so dehydration means, so the first thing is the alcohol will treat with the with the catalyst. What is that catalyst we can use? For example, we can use the H2SO4. Okay, we will get an alkene group here as a end product. Okay, so for that we are using a protonic acid, whether it is a H2SO4 and H3PO4. Fine. So the reaction is, I'll give one example, like if you take like this group, okay, C2H5OH. Okay, so ethanol, it will undergo the reaction with the protonic acid of H2SO4, okay, at 443 Kelvin. Okay, so you will get, what I said here, you will get an alkene group. So that only we will get, we can write this one CH3, CH2 and OH, right? So that you will get a end product of CH2, double bond CH2. Okay, so it is a ethane, right? Methane. So there is a double bond is there. So you will get a ethane group. That means alkene group you will get as a end product. And I also said there is a removal of H2O. Okay, so there is a removal of H2O. Here there is a OH is there. In that there will be a hydrogen molecule. Okay, totally it will eliminate the H2O here. So there is a removal of H2O. This is what happening. Okay, so but internally what is happening in the reaction, we have to know about the mechanism, then only we can come to know what is happening between the acid, protonic acid, and also the particular starting material of ethanol. Okay, that means C2H5OH. Right, we will see the mechanism now, so you will get a better clarification. So the first mechanism step is, okay, so the mechanism step is, first one is like the formation of protonated alcohol. Formation of protonated alcohol, first step. The second step is, the second one is, there is a formation of carbocation. Okay, the third step is, okay, third one is, there is a formation of ethane. Okay, as you know earlier, we have the product of ethane, no? Right? So there is a formation of ethane. So these are the three things happening in the particular mechanism when the alcohol is undergo the cleavage of oxygen and O bond. Okay, in the particular reaction of dehydration. Okay, so these are the things we are going to check now. The first step is, what is the first step? What I said earlier, we have to know about the formation of protonated alcohol. Protonated alcohol. So that I am taking the starting material. So how you can write the CH3C? There is a bond of H. There will be three bond. No, CH3. We can write like this, right? So CH2. You can write like this. So OH. There is a bond of OH, right? So OH. I have written here. But in the oxygen atom, no, there will be a lone pair. You know that. So you have to mention that lone pair also. Okay, according to that lone pair only, there is a resonance structure will come, and also we will get a protonated alcohol also. So that, okay, then for that reaction we are using a protonic acid, no, right? From that protonic acid we will get the H plus, right? Merit. So it is a equilibrium reaction. What is that? If you are getting this product, from this product you will also get the starting material. Okay, that means ethanol. So that it is a equilibrium reaction. It is a fast one. It is a fast one. The second step is slow one. Okay, the last one is also the equilibrium reaction. All the three reaction also equilibrium reaction. Fine. So the ethanol is react with the H plus of protonic acid. Okay, so we will get the product of protonated alcohol. That means ethyl oxonium ion. Okay, as you know, the first product I said the protonated alcohol. Okay, let's see the reaction how it is happening. So here there is a lone pair, no? So this will come and attack the particular protonated, the H plus is there, no? Proton, okay? It will come and attack the particular proton here, so that only we will get a product of, like, see here, H, okay? This is the one formation, CH3, you can write like that, okay? Then after that CH2 you can write like that, but here this O, that means oxygen will come and attack the particular H plus, right? So that how you will get the structure. Okay, so this particular lone pair is move here, so that only you will get plus sign here. It is electron always having a minus sign, right? So once it's move here, what will happen? The oxygen will having a plus sign here, so that I am putting a plus sign here. And after that, there is a bond formation between the oxygen and hydrogen, because this is having a minus, this is having a plus. Okay, so it will attract to each other and it will make a bond of OH bond. Got it, all of you? Right. And here there will be a retain of H here. So you just write like that. Okay, fine. Then here the acid is. Okay, so this is a structure of ethyl oxonium ion. That means you can say protonated alcohol. What is that? It is a protonated alcohol. As per the first step, we got the protonated alcohol. This is called protonated alcohol. Alcohol, no? This is OH is alcohol, no? This is protonated alcohol. Okay, according to the protonic acid, we got the protonated alcohol. This is the first step. Okay, and also this is a first reaction. Okay, the second one, second step is, as you know earlier, we are going to get a, okay, what is that? It is a carbocation, right? Carbocation is the slower step. And it is a rate determining step it is. Okay. So again, I am taking this one. Okay. The end product of first step. So here I can write CH3. Okay. And CH2. Okay. So here what and all is there? Plus and H. Here also one H. Okay. And you know that there is a lone pair here. You know that, right? Here there is a retain of lone pair. As it is, it will carry. Okay. So here what will happen? Already it got a plus sign here, so it won't react with any other thing. But here there is a bond, no, here it will move here. Why it is moving? Because this group, no, ethanol is, no, it having a one bulky group. Here there is a one bulky group, that means CH3 here. So that only what happened, this bond will, okay, there is a I effect, no, am I right? There is a CH3 group is present in the particular alcohol, ethanol. The tertiary alcohol, if you take, no, it has more reactive. Why? Means the increased number of alkyl group will be present, right? In the tertiary alcohol, there is a CH3, and here also CH3. There are three bulky groups. So that only what happened, there is a cleavage will happen easily in the carbon. Okay, so that only we know that the reactive of the element, reactive of the particular group, the tertiary alcohol is more than the secondary and the primary. Okay, but we are talking about only the primary one. Here only the one bulky group is there. Okay, what will happen? The cleavage, we are talking about only the cleavage, no, carbon and oxygen cleavage, right? So the carbon and oxygen cleavage will happen, because of that this bond will move here. Okay, so what happened, this is the equilibrium reaction as I said earlier. So what will what you will get the product, it is a carbocation, right? So CH3, okay, fine. And here H will be there, here H will be there, but this bond is moved here, no, so that you will get a plus sign here. Okay, the minus won't be, right? You will get a plus sign here, fine. So after that what happened, you know that if this bond will move, means it will, there is a cleavage, cleavage is happened, no, between the carbon and the oxygen bond. So that what happened, here HOH, that means H2O is eliminated. Got it? So the, I said earlier, it is a removal reaction, removal of water molecule. It is a dehydration reaction, right? Okay. So that only it's happened, there is a removal of H2O. What is the third step? It is into, the third step is, as you know earlier, it is a formation of ethane, right? It is a formation of ethane, right? So that I am taking the carbocation here. You know that you have to write like that, CH3 and the CH2. Okay, there is a carry of plus sign here, so that I have to plus put the plus sign here. It is a equilibrium reaction, right? So that what happened, after removal of this one, okay, no bond will move here, but here there is a carbon-carbon bond is there. No, in this carbon, okay, in this carbon there is attachment of particular hydrogen. This bond will move here, okay, this bond will move here, and it will make a double bond. Got it? So that only we got a structure of ethane. Okay, so that this hydrogen will move here, so that CH2 double bond CH2. Okay, so this hydrogen which we have added in the starting step, we have added the H plus, no, because of the protonic acid, right? In the first step we have added the H plus. Got it, all of you? There is a H plus we have added here because of the protonic acid. The same H plus is eliminated in the third step. Okay, so that we got the ethane here. Okay, so these are the three steps you have to follow to formation of the particular, what is it, ethane, according to the cleavage of carbon and oxygen bond in the dehydration reaction. Okay, so this is the dehydration reaction of the particular compound, that is, no, alcohol. We are doing the same way, okay, according to the mechanism. Got it, all of you? Okay, we will see in the next video. So before that, if you didn't subscribe our channel, please like, share and subscribe our channel, and click the bell icon also, so then only you will get a notification. Yeah, every day morning 6:45 a.m. you will do the live chat with me, and if you have any doubts on that, you just comment in the comment section. I will do answer it. Yeah, thank you so much.